I'm Sadhana Jackson. I'm a physician. I'm a physician scientist. And I am actually a pediatric neuro-oncologist, which is a long word for I am a doctor for children who takes care of children who have cancer, and cancer specifically in their brain. And I work at the National Institutes of Health, specifically NINDS.
And I've been NIH.
Yes, NIH, yes. And I've been there for 5 years. And today I'm going to be leading my two children in an experiment called How Hot Is It? So we're going to be talking about a few science things, and I'm going to be asking them questions. They're going to be smiling cute like this, and they're going to be answering the questions. So can you tell me what your name is, how old are you, and what do you like about science? I'll start with you. What's your name?
My name is Evangeline, and how I like the way science is that it does explosions. And so I like it really much. And
how old are you?
I'm 4 and I'm about to be 5. And I like too about science, that I love it because all the explosions happen.
All about the explosions, okay.
And I just like it when we get to see the chemicals and stuff.
Okay. You know that there's going to be no explosions for the experiment today, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Benjamin, what is your name and how old are you and what do you like about science?
My name is Benjamin. I'm 8 years old. And also, I like the explosions too.
Oh my goodness.
We learn explosions from the Loud House because Lisa is one of the science girls from the Loud House.
But you do understand that I'm a scientist. Before you knew about the Nickelodeon show and science, that I am a scientist, right?
Yeah.
Okay. I guess I'm not as convincing. Okay. So today we're going to be doing an experiment called How Hot Is It? And it's going to be kind of using your senses, okay? Can you tell me what the 5 senses are, Benjamin and Evie? What are the 5 senses?
See. Okay. Hear, smell, taste, and smell.
You said smell already. See, hear, taste,
sense,
touch.
I mean touch.
Yeah, you can feel things.
I was thinking of touch.
You're thinking of touch, okay. So today we're gonna talk about how hot is it in the context of different temperatures of water. So we're going to have really cold water, and so this one has ice. We're going to have hot water. This one, I warmed up some water in the microwave, and then I put it in this kind of coffee mug thing so it can stay warm. And this one will be room temperature water, so I'm just going to pour it from this pitcher. And what I'm going to ask you guys to do, to tell the audience, what does it feel like when you put your hand in the cold, and then you put it in the room temperature, and then you put it in the hot, and then you put it in room temperature. Like, what does it feel like, okay?
It feels like it's really soft, and I like it because it's really, what's that word again?
I don't know what you're trying to say.
It's really like, I like the texture of it.
You like the texture of it. Okay, so in order to say that something is cold, we're gonna put a little bit of blue food coloring. 1, 2. Let's pour a little bit of the room temperature water because we already have the ice.
Whoa, that looks blue.
That looks blue, okay.
Is it the ocean?
What do you think? And then, do you want to do 2 drops of red?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll pour in the hot water. Just hot water.
I don't feel how hot.
Ah. It's hot? What does it taste like?
Water.
Oh my goodness. Okay. Is it going to be swirling around?
Oh no, it's blood.
No, it's not blood. You just know that it's hot water. That's really hot. Maybe I should put some of the room temperature water in there. This coffee mug thing does a good job. Okay. And then just to be safe, because it's your little precious hands that I care about, let's put some of the ice in there. So then it'll be kind of room temperature, but kind of, yeah, that's good. Okay, perfect.
Not that hot.
Okay, and then the room temperature.
I felt hotter.
You felt hotter, okay. We're just going to have it be room temperature. All right.
I already know.
So you both started to put your hand in the room temperature, into the hot water. So put your hands in the hot water. What does that feel like?
It feels like
it actually warm. Feels warm. Actually warm.
Warm.
Not hot.
Not hot? Okay.
It actually looks like it's actual blood.
But do you think it's actual blood?
Yes.
We're gonna put both red and blue in this one.
So mix it in.
And then what do red and blue make?
Purple.
Okay, how does your hand feel now that you put it in room temperature?
It feels cold.
It feels warm.
It feels warm?
This one is warmer than the other.
Okay, and put it back in the hot and see how that feels. But does your hand feel any hotter or colder now that you put it in the room temperature water?
Hot. It feels a little cold.
That the room temperature water feels cold now? Okay. Now, the final test, let's put your hand in the cold water.
Can't reach.
Oh, you can't reach. Okay. Sit up.
It's not that cold.
It's not that cold. Why do you think it's not that cold?
Well, it is kind of cold.
Well, why do you think it's not that cold?
Because it's not in the Arctic.
Because remember, you put it in the warm water. So, you know, when you were to touch hot, the hot sidewalk or the hot, yeah, you want to put your hand back in the warm water. And I bet you like your hand in the warm water now, right? You know, when we get in the car sometimes and it's hot outside and you're like, don't let me touch the seatbelt. Don't let me touch the seatbelt, right?
Because I'm the closest to the sun.
Oh, the car where we park it is closest to the sun?
Yeah, my part is
closest. And so when you feel the metal part, it's really hot, right? And so what you know is when you get into the car, you don't want to feel that seatbelt part anymore, do you? Why? What happens if you feel the seatbelt?
If you feel the seatbelt, it's the metal thing. And then when you touch it, it gets hotter and hotter.
Right, right. So that's the same thing with this water temperature. You go from cold, cold, cold. If you were to go to hot, it feels really good. Sometimes when we're in air conditioning.
I feel good.
This one is actually a little turning. It's not that. It's getting hot.
It's getting hot. You know why it's getting hot? Because you felt the cold, 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 and then you went to the room temperature, and now the room temperature feels warm. That was the whole point of this experiment. How differently you sense things when you go from cold to hot. No, there's no point in that, Ben. There's no point in that. So that's the same thing. Like sometimes when we're inside in a building or in our house and we're in air conditioning, we're like, oh, it feels so good in here. Then we go outside and it's like 90 degrees and we go for our afternoon walk. We're like, oh, it's not that hot outside. And then we're outside for like 20 minutes and we're like sweating because the air conditioning has already kind of come off of our body, but we had felt cold for a little while. And then we're no longer cold and then we're hot and we're sweating.
Yeah, I want to put some of these hot.
Okay. So what questions do you have for me about this science experiment?
It was great. And like, I liked it because it was like so cool. And I liked it because I like the blue one the better. And I like when we mix the blue and the red together. It looks so cool.
Okay, that's enough. We don't want to use all the food coloring. I think they know that it's hot. And what did you learn about senses and how you feel things differently with cold and hot, Benjamin?
Cold and hot?
Yes. What did you learn?
I learned that hot is very hot, and cold is very cold, and then you mix it together and it's warm.
But you knew that before. The question is about sensing. When you go from cold to room temperature.
And then you put it back in the hot.
Yeah, what differences did you have in your feeling of your hand?
Cold? It's cold, really cold. But then when you go in here, you feel the warm and the cold. Right. It's half cold. And then when you put it back in, it's super hot.
I already know, but yes, I will try it. Cold, cold. But when I put it in hot, nice and warm. But if I were to just put it in the hot, I would have felt like it was hotter than what it was. But because I was in the cold first, it kind of made me not feel so hot. Not everybody just wants their hand in hot water. So,
unless you're a cold baby.
Unless if you're a cold baby.
Like her.
So, sit down, please.
And how old are you? And how, what are you like about science?
Oh, okay. So I am 38, but don't tell anybody because I usually say I'm 28, but I have to say my age or else Benjamin will call me out. Sit down.
Yep, I'm calling you out.
And I got into science because I remember somebody came to my class, this was like fourth grade, and it was somebody's dad who was a scientist, and he came in a white jacket, and he did some experiments for us. And guess what, Evie? He put some baking soda with vinegar in the vinegar, and they started to explode, just like the experiment we did last week. And I was like, I wanna be a scientist! So now I see what you guys are saying and the fact that you like science and explosions, because the very first time that I saw him do an experiment in the class.
Kids always like explosions.
Kids always like explosions. Adults like explosions too. You know, that's what people see in the game.
I like the fact of the explosions because it's like an entrance when they come to my brain. And
it's like,
it can have 100 explosions, and I wish it could have like 20 explosions because I like it.
So kids at home, you can do this fun and easy experiment. You can have a little bit of food coloring. You could also do it with no food coloring. We just thought it was cool because we like to mix colors, and red and blue make purple. So for hot water, you need that. You need some ice to make cold water. And you need just room temperature water. The food coloring helps to just kind of figure out which ones are which temperatures. And really three bowls, just a very simple at-home experiment to do. And you need some cool kids. I'm sure you can find them on any corner. And a grown-up, definitely to handle the hot water to make sure it's not too hot. And you too can do this. So thanks for joining, and we'll see you next time.
Bye.
Why are you doing that?
Bye.
Bye, say bye, Benjamin.